Yo, what is up, guys? So I got a few questions about solo queuing. So here are some quick tips that might help you to get a higher rank. If you like, my first big tip is like really use your mic because it's just so helpful when you can just speak to your team when you have someone low, or you can say the Valkyrie's one shot. You can really help your team out. You cannot really ping that, you know? You cannot really ping that you shot a Wraith or a Valkyrie one shot. You cannot really ping that. So, and if you like want to rotate somewhere, just go to another place. You can tell them, hey guys, I don't have really good loot. Let's just let this go away. I'm not ready for the fight. It's just so helpful, you know? And you might even learn new people. Learn to know new people. So yeah. For tip two, I would say, what's the most important is the positioning in this game. So you obviously you just want. Jesus Christ, bro, my English is so bad. So you just want to scan beacons and take the best position in zone. I will not recommend you go camp every game because that's really boring. It's probably the most efficient way to get positive RP, that's for sure, but it's really gonna be really boring. So for tip two, I would say just go to the best position in zone. And you not really like you need the most high ground or anything, but for the most important part is that you have the most cover, because let's say this is World's Edge and this is the end zone right here, and I can have high ground right here, but there's not really much cover. So let's say there's a team behind these,
Let's
let's
go
say
this way.
these are supply bins, for instance. There's a team right here and we have high ground, but we have no cover. So it's not really all about high ground, it's about who has the most cover in the end games, so you won't get shot as much. For tip 3, I would say don't try to start a fight. Try to third party as much as you can and just clean up as much fights as you can. So that's just gonna be most of the time easy KP, just because people are just done fighting or just still fighting and they're probably really low, have some knocks, you know, finish the down knocks, you get the KP for it. Yeah, that is just really important that you clean up and you clean up quick, you know. You don't want to take a fight really too long, otherwise you're just gonna get third partied yourself. You can maybe, if you have like a fight with one team and you knock one really quick, you can try to end the fight really quick by really play aggressively and just push the other last two with your whole team. So I would not recommend fighting longer than maybe like 30 seconds. If you don't get the first knock, just leave, because the third parties are crazy in this game, especially on World's Edge and King's Canyon. This was crazy. For Stormpoint, not so much, because the map is really big. Hello, can you stop, please? Thank you. On Stormpoint, for me, it was pretty easy to get Masters because the map was so big and I don't got third partied a lot. On World's Edge, a little bit harder, the third parties were a little bit more there, and for King's Canyon it was a horrible map for ranked because the cities are so close to each other that you get third partied a lot. So for tip number four, I would say that it's very important that you don't play too much ranked in one day, because it's not really fun, because it's most of the time just playing really safe, and yeah, if you make one mistake you're dead and you're gonna lose points. So for me, what I did is when I gained like 600 RP or four, maybe 400 on a bad day, then it was already enough for me, you know. It's basically halfway to one diamond tier, so it's pretty good if you get that on one day. And if you're gonna lose a couple of rounds straight after each other and you lose like minus 48, you're losing a lot of points. If you lose 2 or 3 point games, you already lose like 100 to 150 RP. So yeah, that's one good game, you know. So it's really important to take some breaks and don't play too much ranked, especially solo queuing when you are queuing up with random teammates that maybe drain a lot of energy from you. Alright, for tip number 5, I'm gonna give you a tip that I personally don't really like myself, but it works. So, your loadout is very important. I would recommend one close range weapon, something like a 9. If you have a Gibby on your team, in ranked you see a lot of Gibbies, it's really good to have a shotgun, Peacekeeper, a Mastiff, something like that for a bubble fight, but or a vault. And your secondary would be something like a long range weapon, so something like an R301 is really good. You see a lot of people use snipers in rank. I'm not really a big fan of them because I think people that snipe are really annoying. And most of the time they're not really good. If you push a team like that, you can roll them really easy, but that's most of the time, not all the time. So yeah, you can just use snipers, and when you get maybe a knock on the other side of the map and they are getting third partied, you get some KP out of that, so it works. So that's why everyone is doing it. And you just want to grief as much teams as possible, because like, if you grief one team, that's already one team closer to the victory, you know? And the victory is 100 points, so that's important as well. For tip number 6, I would say play a kind of mobility legend, something like Raid, Pathfinder, Octane, Valkyrie, Horizon, so you can maybe like escape. Sometimes I had some really dumb teammates as well in my games. They just pushed two teams. There was one team behind us, they were chasing us down, and I said it like 2 times, like, guys, don't fight this, we are gonna get sandwiched and we're gonna die. So the two guys just did not listen to me, and they just full-on pushed that one squad. They did not even down one of the one squad. They both died by the one squad, and then the other squad still came in our back, so they started fighting. We could easily just leave that place or waited a little bit on the side, and they were gonna fight and we could third party them, but no, we just got third partied. But I still managed to escape. Of course they got mad at me, they say, yeah, you have to help me, but even if I helped them, we could have killed maybe the one team, but they still were down, so then I have to fight one full team on my own. That's not gonna work in rank in Diamond when everyone is still Master and Predator. So I escaped, and I kinda redded a little bit, I third partied some fights, I got max KP and I got second place with it, so I still got a nice RP. I think I got like 130 points for that game, so I'm not complaining. They were really mad at me, they just left the game, they were, I think, Diamond 4, they had nothing to lose probably. So yeah, that's what you have to go through when you're solo queuing. I think the most hardest part is probably just keeping cool and try to communicate as best as you can and stay nice. That's gonna get you far. Alright, these were my tips for solo queuing. These are very good and basic tips, they work. For me, they worked at least. If you have any questions about these tips, or just any questions about solo queuing, what you wanna know, just ask them in the comments and I will probably react to them. If you liked the video, please leave a like, that helps. Oh my god, these airstrikes are so annoying. Just every time I try to explain something, make a video, there's just an airstrike in my video. But please leave a like if you liked the video, because that helps the channel a lot, you know. So yeah, I hope you guys have a wonderful day.